And on this online thing, Judy Corker destroyed it. I mean, it was unanimous. Let's put it this way. If they had this 50 years ago, she would have been in when she was still calling the games. You know, she wouldn't have had to wait. Like in other Hall of Fames, you have to wait 5 years. She was so good, they would have put her in right away. Mrs. Judy Corker, Westwood, New Jersey, the voice of St. Joe's Athletics. A school nurse from 93 to 2015, the mother of two SJR graduates, Michael, the class of 76, and Jeffrey, class of 84. But she's best known in here tonight for having earned two specific titles over the course of her SJR career. Biggest SJR fan and the voice of the Green Knights. She received more online nominations than any other individual for this Hall of Fame. She was the play-by-play voice of the football team in the fall, called the action in the gym every winter for the basketball team, and later for wrestling, manned the press box to announce our home baseball games in the spring, and that is not easy with the weather, but Judy was always there. In addition, starting in the late 90s, she succeeded brother William Cushing as the official archivist of all St. Joe's Athletics and clipped hundreds and hundreds of programs, which a lot of that was used to putting this information together today. Truth be told, Judy is a bit of a maverick when it came to her broadcast style. While journalists today do play-by-play with particular biases of their networks, when Judy began her play-by-play career, objectivity was the order of the day. It was not necessarily her strong suit. She was never much doubt which team she was rooting for. She wore her heart on her sleeve, every SJU score, with great passion and enthusiasm. When the other team scored, she said their names, but there was no enthusiasm. She famously signed it with her students every year for the student-faculty basketball game. I mean, she is St. Joe's. She is St. Joe's, and her favorite memory. You know what? I'm not going to tell her favorite memory because I want her to tell her favorite memory as only she can. The voice of St. Joe's, the greatest
of voice!
It's great on you.
Beautiful. Yeah.
Barry and Scott, thank you guys for my quick, nice introduction.
Move the mic closer.
Thank you for the... unaccustomed as I am to public speaking. She said
that's all the time you want, right?
And I did thank Scott and what's the big guy's name, Barry? You know, you get this old and you lose your memory. But I think I have to thank the number of you that wrote me in. I never would have imagined this could have happened to me. And I do get very emotional. But anyway, it would help if I put my glasses on. So thanks to the boys, and this SJR Voices, you know, we always had a voicing Star Spangled Banner, and that was from the Dramatic Club. So they always helped out. But recognition for a job well done. So at the risk of signaling out naming of players, I have to feed those egos. They love to hear their name. So I tried to call it as I saw it. Of course, I never got the yardage right, you know. The crowd helped. At halftime, we did YMCA, and the mothers did a terrific job dancing in stands. It was great. At the end of the game, every now and then we'd play Sweet Caroline, and the crowd would go wild. Neil Simon, they loved it. There were a couple of instances I remember. One at Giant Stadium, on a kickoff, we were playing, I think we were playing Seton Hall, and Pat McManus took the kickoff and ran it all the way back for a touchdown. You talk about exciting, wow. And we had one recently, I think it was in 13. We were playing Bergen Catholic. And Mark Fassati, I'm sure some of you remember him, intercepted a pass and ran it back for a touchdown. So exciting. And that was the fun of the game. And that was the fun of the announcer, letting these guys know how great they were. Basketball. Too many individual stars. JR, of course, the leader. And J.R., I never knew you could speak like that. What a job you did. There are so many individual stars in basketball, I wouldn't even name half of them. But I have to tell you about one night the gym was packed. And after the game was over, you know, everybody kind of left the gym. And from the top row in the bleachers on the other side, this man made his way down, and he's coming across the court, and I'm looking at him thinking, he's coming at me. So he walks up to me and he says, I have never been at such a boring basketball game. And I said, thank you, sir, come again. Guess which school he was from. I'm not telling you. What else? We had a few stars in baseball. Tommy La Stella just had a nice home run out in California. It's Rob Kaminsky's pitching. And John Henry played third base. Great kid. So that's that. And wrestling I did a little bit with. All I did there was announce the lineups. I didn't know anything about wrestling. But the kids loved to hear the name. So that's what I did. So in today's world, this is saying, kindness over everything. St. Joe's is simply the best, and in my opinion, the best of all the rest. Thank you.